Behind us, the Uluguru Mountains. We just passed Morogoro and are on the way to Mikumi and will stay the first night in Kisolanza.
It was in 2015 that we traveled to Zambia for the first time, beginning in Dar es Salaam and winding our way down to Iringa and then subsequently in Mbeya, near the Zambian border.
Stört gleich den Rasen.
After setting up camp in Mbeya, our first camp,
we made it through the Zambian border into Zambia in only 2 hours, including changing money. We're driving down into Isoka to buy some vegetables and food. It's not really visible on the road either that there is such a large village or small town. And we have still about 2 hours to darkness to reach the waterfalls where we intend to camp.
The grasslands are fantastic here and the roads are almost empty.
Und ein paar Fische können wir, du hast auch keine Fische, die Dry Fish auch nicht?
Dry Fish, no, no.
Das ist auch besser.
Fried Fish, yes. Dry Fish, no. So, the first night at Chipuma Falls. It's quite cold, it's still 8 degrees. In the night time it was maybe 6 degrees Celsius only. We definitely cannot complain about the scenery or the loneliness and remoteness of this place. Nobody is around except us. This is the true Zambia. High yellow grass and lots of water everywhere. We will be going to Kapisha Hot Springs tomorrow, stay there another night, and then continue to Mpika to fill up supplies, change money, etc. And on the day after that, have a very long trip, I believe, through South Rangwa National Park on the route number 5, which is an off-road day to reach Mfuwe, which is the main village in just outside South Rangwa National Park. Then we have some days in South Rangwa National Park and are heading to Petauke, another demanding off-road route along the Luangwa River. We're quite happy to be with two vehicles on these roads. And then after reaching Petauke, we will head for Lower Zambezi. Again, enter it via a 4 or 5 hours off-road trip near the Chakwenga River, which leads to the Chongwe area a couple of hours later.
We make camp in Kapisha, and it's even colder in the mornings than it was at the last campsite. Everybody runs around in woolen caps and makes fire even in the early morning. But wait, it's time for a hot bath.
Mark from Kapisha Hot Springs, he had told us that it should be about 7 to 8 hours from Kapisha to Mfuwe, where we want to go today.
Nabalia Chiefdom Headquarter, 123 kilometers.
To get to South Rangwa on the famous 05 route. We have been warned about the steepness of the escarpments and deflated our tires a bit to increase the grip and soften the ride.
Schön, ne? Jetzt geht's runter. Gemeint hat er, also die letzten zwei, wo wir durch sind, die sind nicht mehr, sind unten nicht angekommen.
Sondern runtergefallen.
Ja, den einen haben sie beerdigt da oben auf dem Felsen.
There had only been about 2,000 cars before us this year on the famous 05 road. Several times we had to clear trees that before had been overturned by elephants.
Yeah, looks like we're the first in a couple of days, huh?
It is a beautiful road to go downhill, but I now understand why one of Mark's cars had a broken rear differential after going this road uphill.
Here we have a nice river, the first river crossing. We are quite happy that we have a bridge here. Okay. Schnell! Oh, schon eine drinnen. So, there are some kudus and antelopes nearby, so we assume that there are not too many lions around, at least not the hungry creed. It's amazing how many animals there are, despite the low river levels. Massive amounts of birds. Half of them I don't even see, I just can hear them.
Das sagenhafte Ruhe, ja. Keine Flugzeuge, keine Autos. Herrlich.
We had an elephant in the camp this night, the early evening, and he went. He came from here through the electrical fence, which was installed newly a week ago or so, to keep out the elephants and hippos. And then he went right here between the cars and tents, and I saw his out of the tent, I saw his trunk swinging forth and back and checking out the tent lines. And he decided that he can't really move through the tent lines. Very gentle elephant. So he turned back and missed the fridge, luckily, which was full of food, and went back again. And then people tried to chase him out of the compound.
Hier. Dann ist er zu uns rübergekommen, oder? Und dann hat er wahrscheinlich gemerkt, dass es dort nicht weitergeht.
Der stand hier unter diesem Panda, oder wie? Ja. So, der war doch größer, oder?
Der hat sich gebuckt.
Echt?
Ja, da hat er gesagt, hat sich so geduckt. Wir saßen ja auch im Bett, oder?
Ja, there's a bit of a monkey problem also. Today we have been driving from Fuwe to Chipata, where we had lunch, and then to Petauke, where we'll arrive shortly. I was amazed about the fantastic road, except the last part to Petauke, which is not yet has not yet been repaired. The other thing that is outstanding is that we have not seen a single police checkpoint or police man on the street or woman the whole day, which is unthinkable in Tanzania, and still the country is not falling apart. High grass and hills, and then after Chipata the landscape becomes a bit more dry. Dancing sun behind us, chicken run in front and away. Morning after a short night in Petauke, and we are heading for Loangwa Bridge for breakfast, and then on to Lower Zambezi National Park. The mood is good, the road is bumpy, and there is another humpy. Ay, ay, ay. For me, the fascinating part about Zambia are the grasslands. Right here the grass is not so high, but the light is nice. It's right before the Luangwa Bridge, and normally we see a lot of wrecks, but this one is still burning. It's quite amazing. Totally burnt out. I'm not sure if they just set it on fire. It's quite hot. Looks like grain that is burning, rice or something like that. Not the ideal lunch site. We are on the Leopard Hill Road without really wanting to be there, because we aimed for the northern route into Lower Zambezi National Park. But kind of talked too much and lost view of the GPS, and the GPS, as usual, was doing its own thing. Jürgen apparently went through the national park and will go the other road without knowing that we are not behind him. Jürgen is far, far away, and nobody knows that we are here, except for God and the leopard. Now we go down the escarpment once again, this time through the Zambezi River. It's just a few years ago it has been reopened or re-prepared, this road. And I can very well imagine that it overgrows within a year or so. Somebody has definitely cut the grass for us. The problem is that, contrary to the road into South Luangwa, that this road is a bit wet and slippery, and we just did a bit of drifting.
We were extremely relieved when we arrived at Mpu camp at Lower Zambezi National Park just before sunset. However, there was no trace yet of our friends, who were taking the other route down into Lower Zambezi. It was only hours later when they finally arrived in complete darkness.
Sopa is still determined to cook something while we ate just chips and nuts.
Aber wenn du unten ankommst, ist super schön. Also alleine schon die Sicht. Und dann, es ist viel schöner als die letzte Tour, oder? Fand ich. Und um 12 waren wir beim Gate. Also ich frage noch beim Gate. Ich sagte, ja, wie lange es dauert? Er meinte, ja, so roughly 2 hours to the river, oder? Das heißt, 2 hours to the river, das ist ja extrem schnell. Und so ein bisschen bist du schnell.
Ja. Aber
wenn du dann mal unten bist, das zieht sich extrem in die Länge, oder? Ewig lang, das sind nochmal 100 Kilometer. Wo du nicht schnell fahren kannst, zur Sandpiste.
Ja, das war bei uns
aber,
auch.
Aber überall Tiere, ja. Also kannst du dich gut verfahren, oder? Also ohne GPS hättest du mich total verfahren.
Ich habe diesmal die Luft nicht abgelassen und das habe ich schon ziemlich bereut dann, weil ich teilweise hinten ausgebrochen bin und war es ein bisschen feucht, oder dann sind wir gerutscht.
Das irgendwie hört nicht mehr auf, oder? Ich dachte zuerst um 4 sind wir da, dann waren wir um 7 waren wir beim Gate, oder?
Thank you.